Everybody comes to Hollywood. They wanna make it in the neighborhood. They like the smell of it in Hollywood. How could it hurt you when it looks so good? I lost my memory.
Reports are coming through of the latest attack by gangs of youths in hoodies. Two old age pensioners were assaulted in the street at 10 p.m. last night. This marks the dramatic increase in crime we have seen from youth groups in the last 6 months.
Have you seen this?
This is it.
They've gone too far. We've got to do something about it.
What are we to do, Matthew? It's not good just targeting one gang, one area, one city. The problem is like a disease throughout the entire world. We need to come down on all youths, the entire country's population of youths, all of them.
You're so right, darling.
To every Prime Minister in the world, youths have gone too far. They must be punished. We must come down hard on them. Mosquito alarms, special housing units, curfews. They must be contained. All of them.
With breaking news from Westminster for BBC News 24. In very unprecedented circumstances, Parliament have passed a vote to separate youths from the adult world. From midnight tonight, all youths will be placed in special zones. Curfews will be enforced. Emergency laws have been passed.
It is a perfectly rational and reasonable response to the youth of today. They must be controlled. And since they have not responded to more lenient methods of control, they must be handled harshly.
Yes, Prime Minister. I think the matter is settled then. We shall implement the law as discussed, as fast as possible, and with the cooperation of every country in the world.
Good.
Stop!
Stop! My name is Adam, and I need to talk to you.
Just take him away, vicious youth!
Go on, take him down.
Oh, vicious.
Take him
down. Oh, let me go! What are you doing? Oh. You can't grab me, I'm a solicitor!
Vicious youth.
At least we're together.
Yeah, I suppose so. Don't you feel lost?
lost and abandoned. I miss my dog.
Thank you.
I hate these mosquito alarms.
You must have been running outside.
The controls are working. Finally, the youths are under our thumb.
Help! Help! I've done nothing wrong.
I'm just the young guy who wants to save his friends. I didn't mean
any harm.
In an unprecedented turn of events, recent footage from our news helicopter sees the residents of Youth's area happy and controlled, whilst the adult world has crumbled, with crime at an all-time high. The Prime Minister is said to be shocked by the news, and according to official sources inside Westminster, is considering the offer of an apology to Youth's, along with a declaration of their release from Youth's area.
There's been a rumour that the Prime Minister might want to offer some kind of unification agreement between the residents of Youth's area and the outside world. How would you feel about this?
Well, we might do, but we want, as long as we're no longer called Youths, and if we had some sort of influence over, you know, major government decisions, we want to be listened to and respected by adults. We want to be seen as mature and capable, and we want an apology, and then maybe we would. Maybe we would unite.
Jenny from Youth's Area, thank you very much. Back to Vicky in the studio.
All adults hereby apologise for our treatment of young people. From now on, we will listen to what they have to say and treat them with more respect. Young people are free.
Housing unit.
Cut.
Wait, it's not enough smoke yet.
Oh, cut. Oh.
It does a DVD.
Uh-oh, brain bug. Oh, God. Oh, God, I'm going to be...
Okay,
oh,
now,
go. Brain fog. I'm confused.
How about putting your hands on your head?
Ah.
Cut! You were meant to say that.
Right.
Wait for more of this stuff. Wait, it's just when the smoke comes, you can act.
This is a bit heavy, isn't it?
I should never have had that second cup of tea.
Hit the bread button for me.
Alright.
Ah! Okay, now!
Ah! Brain bog! Oh, brain bog. Oh.
Hit it again.
Oh!
brain fog! Come on, quick!
Ah! Brain bog! I'm getting confused. Oh god, I'm going to be attacked by monsters.
Okay, scene 5, take 3.
And action!
Jane, don't worry. We're alright, aren't we? I know this isn't a real one, there's rules and stuff, but...
Rolling!
Cuffled.
Scene 2, take 2.
Action!
To every Prime Minister.
Now, I've got the brain fog idea from Blake Edwards, who directed the Pink Panther movies and is currently married to Julie Andrews, 88 and still going. He suffers from CFS, which is chronic fatigue syndrome. I looked it up on Wikipedia, and then I looked at symptoms. The one of the symptoms was brain fog. I clicked on it, and it said brain fog means you're confused and forgetful. And that's where I got brain fog from.
And that was the bit that you put into the script.
Yes, and I also had trouble sleeping, so that was another way we could do it.
So how did we film the brain fog?
Well,
what did you have to do for that?
We had a smoke machine and we activated it. The smoke, although it was in my face when I was going, oh, Rupert, never ever squirt that much in my face again, please. Zombie, let's go back.